I've gone ahead and logged in as a developer because out of all the admin roles that we have set up, the developer has the least amount of permission to do anything. So I decided to log in as them so that we can see changes as we go along. So let's head into our text editor. And let's go into the, we'll start off with the roles. So we'll go to HTTP, controllers, admins, role controller. And the first thing that we can do is in the index method, which displays all of our roles, we can go ahead and now add the gate. Well, how we're going to do it is going to be if gate, and we need to import gate, allows access roles. Now in here, we can just go ahead and bring that up. And so if that doesn't happen, then import, do it like that. And so if that doesn't happen, then we can just return what class. We need the facade. Okay, so if that doesn't happen, then we'll just return back. Okay, now in the previous episode when we set this up, if we go down to policies, roles policy, where it says access roles, our developer is the only one not listed on this list of admins able to see the access roles or able to access any of the roles. So we'll go back. We're good here. So let's go ahead to our dashboard and we need to refresh. And then we need to go to the roles page just to see if we can get to it. Now these are listed here because we haven't brought in the gates to the back end or to the front end yet. We're just strictly from the back end. So let's go to roles. And as you can see, we were just returned back. Okay, so they can't get to it. And if you don't believe me, we'll come up here and we'll say roles. Okay, just redirected back. So now let's go ahead and do it for the rest of the controller. Okay, so if we scroll down, the next one we have is create. We're going to say if gate allows, and this one is going to be manage roles. Okay, we'll bring this up. Get rid of this, and again, return back. Okay, because they're admins, we really don't need to put any fancy errors or anything. We'll send them back. If you want to do that in your own app, that's perfectly fine because we're already set up to do errors and success messages. So if that's what you want to do, that's fine, but we're not going to do it here. So to store, we don't want anyone who is a non-admin to be able to create a role. So allows manage roles, and again we'll bring this up. Get rid of this, turn back. Okay, come down, and for the show we're gonna do access. So if gate allows access roles, and we can bring this one up. And if not, return back. And there are some shortcuts for these authorizations in the documentation that I showed in the previous video. I'm not going to do that now. I want to keep it as clear as possible so that you can see what it's actually doing, and then you can shorten them on your own. Okay, so edit, update, if gate allows, manage roles. Okay, we'll bring this up. And I forgot the return back. So, turn back. go down. If gate allows manage roles, okay, get rid of that. Turn back. Okay, so now that these are all done, I'm gonna go ahead to the admin controller and the user controller and do the same thing. And then when I'm done, I'll show you what I did. So I'm gonna pause the video and take care of that real quick. Okay, so now in the user controller for the index method, I just put the access users, so it's the same thing for the index page, and manage users for the show page. Okay, update manage users, and then for the admin controller, I left the index the way it is because we've already cut it off in the routes.web.php. The show method, manage admins, the update manage admins, and that's that. Okay, so all these are doing is effectively just cutting off the routes individually for different admins. What we need to do now is we need to have a way of bringing the gates from the back end and the policies from the back end to the front end. Okay, now the only way that I've found that's been pretty clean in doing this is to go to the handle inertia middleware. Okay, and in here we just want to customize the authenticated user that's coming from the back end to the front end. We just want to add some more things to that user so that we can pick different parts of the front end that we don't want, like buttons or links or anything like that. So how we would do that is we're going to create another key in here, and it's going to be called auth, and that's going to equal function. We're going to open it up with some curly brackets, and we need a comma down here. Okay, so now we're going to create a variable. We're going to call it user, and this user is going to be the auth user. Okay, because we need to customize the authenticated user. So now we're going to return user. Have an error, might go away, hang on, let's try it, let's keep going. User, if it is the authenticated user, then we're going to return the can key, and this can key is going to have an array. Okay, and then we're going to have manage admins equals user can manage admins. Okay, and this is how we're going to be able to call it in the front end. So return user can, and if it's not the authenticated user, need a comma up here. Okay, if it's not the authenticated user, then we're going to return null. This needs an arrow. Okay, so now let's go to the browser. We're going to open up our inspect tools, and then we're going to go ahead and refresh the page, and then we're going to go to our view dev tools. And now in inertia, okay, if you come down to the props, you see we have a new key in here, auth can manage admins false, which means they won't be able to do anything in terms of touching the admins. Not touching it. We'll be able to go and see it, but we won't be able to do anything with it. So we need to bring this now into the front end. But let's go ahead and finish adding the rest of our keys in here. Okay, so what we can do is just copy, paste, 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 paste. This one is going to be access roles, This one is going to be manage roles. This one's going to be access users. And this one are going to be manage users. Okay. So now, right now our developer is able to see the roles. So the easiest thing we'll be able to do is first cut off this roles link in here. So let's head back into the text editor and let's just close all this up for now. We'll go to resources, JS, components, and the sidebar. Okay, so how we can bring that in now is in the, let's see, in the roles link, we'll add it at the end here. We'll say vif page props auth can access roles, then we'll be able to display roles. So let's go back to our browser. We'll refresh and see if this is still here. So we'll go back and we'll refresh. And now if we go to our sidebar, you see now that that link is now gone and they can't reach it anymore. And if you go to our dev tools and our props, you can see all of the different keys that are available for this user, and everything is false that we put in, except for them being able to access this whole admin dashboard page. Okay, so we can use this to handle all the rest of these. Okay, so let's go back, and now we can take this. We can also do it for the users, because I think it's our moderator. It's someone, I can't remember who off the top of my head, that can't see the users. So now this is going to be access users. And need to put a space in there. Okay, so that's it for our sidebar. Everything else is, everybody else can see the admins, so we're not going to worry about that. So we can close this, and then we can head down to our pages and start adding those to different things. So we'll go admin. Let's start with admins, and we'll start with the index page. So let's head up top. And then now we want to come down to this part of the table. So basically the only two people allowed to touch our admins are going to be the super admin and the admin. So we can hide these actions from the rest of the admins. Okay, so we'll go click there, and this is the edit button. Okay, so in here now we'll put vif page props auth can manage admins. Okay, so now we'll go back to our browser and we'll see if we can see these buttons anymore. So we'll go, we'll refresh, we can close this. Okay, and now you see that whole button section is just gone. And you can fix the styling on this if you want, I'm not going to do it. But yeah, so it's now gone. Okay, so let's head off to the next one. Now, we don't have to do show because we've already cut off access to the show page. So we don't have to worry about adding these there. But if we go to roles and we go to index, head up top, and now we have this button to create. So we need to put, we need to lock that down too, because not everybody's going to have access to creating a role. So vif page props auth can manage roles. Okay, and then we'll go down and we'll do the same thing to that action section. So we'll come here and here and say vif page props auth can manage roles. Okay, and that's it for this one. We don't really have anything in the show page, but now we can go to users index and do the same thing. Here, here. We'll paste it in. One too many spaces. Okay, and now this is manage admins. Oh, sorry, users. Okay, and that should be good. Let's go ahead and see what we have now. So we'll go back, we'll refresh. Okay, and now we already know those are gone. So we'll come back here and see now the developer is not allowed to access the users. Okay, so why don't we log out? And we're going to log in as an admin now. So admin@admin.com, password. Okay, and now we have our admin dashboard back. We have all of our links back. And now we can go to admins. We have our buttons back. Go to roles. We have both of our buttons. Users. Okay, now let's see. We go back to roles. Okay, only the super admin and the admin should be able to access this. The moderator, which is the next one down, shouldn't. So let's go back, log in, and try moderator. Moderator@admin.com, password. Okay, so let's try it. We have access to all of this. Users, we have no buttons. Roles, we have no buttons, but we are able to access it. And admins, we have no buttons. Okay, so fantastic. We have successfully created an admin panel on the back end from scratch, or on the front end from scratch, with our own custom roles and permissions. I'm going to leave it there for here. If you've made it this far, congratulations, because it was a lot. And I'm going to be preparing for our next series, which is also going to be on authentication, but we're going to come at it from a different angle. Okay, so thanks for watching. I'm going to post all of this up to GitHub. And one side note also, we finally made it to 100 subscribers. So thank you everyone who's watched my videos from beginning to end. I really do appreciate it. I never thought I would get up that to 100 subscribers. I just happened to look and there it was. So I want to say thank you and I appreciate you. And have a great day, and I'll see you guys next time.